Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the interference pattern in thin films. So first slide, look at this slide. This is the thin film. So I would like to know the what is the thickness of this particular film. So how to measure it? We cannot use the vernier calipers or screw gauge to measure the thickness of this particular film. So what the technique is there to measure, to find the thickness of the film? Only the technique we have, the interference. So interference is a technique to measure the thickness of the smaller films. So that is it with the thin film. So by using the interference method, we can find the thickness of the film. Here, whatever we are observing, this thickness of the film can be evaluated by using the method is called ellipsometry. The main background regarding the ellipsometry is the interference. So this is one of the instruments to measure the thickness of this particular film. If there is any non-uniform thickness of the film, so we can observe that particular thickness here. So that means there is a variation of thickness on the surface. So here the main reason behind that is the thickness of the film is evaluated by using the technique of interference. Suppose I want to read the hologram. So how to read the hologram can be read by using only the techniques called interference. So let us see the observation on the surroundings. First to look at this peacock feather. Here we observe all the different colors on the peacock feather. So what is the phenomena here? Here the phenomena is also interference. So look at the second observation. Look at the eagle, this butterfly, this particular layer. You can see that there is a different colors. Here there is a thin film is formed on the surface so that it can be observed the different colors by using the interference technique. This is a thin film. So different colors are produced from that. Because why you are getting a different color is when a white light, a sunlight, anything with a white light, polychromatic light which falls on the surface of the thin film, it produces the different colors by the method of interference. So let us observation on the soap film. See, we are observing the different colors on the soap film here. So let me observe one more, the seashell example. Here also we are observing the different colors. When you start observing the oil spread on the water surface, so it also produces the interference. So let me look at this camera lens. On the top you can observe the different colors. Here also there is a thin film. Here also formation of thin film. So if you observe the series also, you are getting the different colors. That is also there is a thin film is there. So how to find the thickness? Only the technique is called interference. So let me look at the soap bubble. You can see the different colors observed on the soap film here. Because in the case of a thin film, the thickness should be in the order of 0.5 micrometers to 10 micrometers. So here also soap bubble is exhibiting the different colors on the soap film. So this is also this is set with the Newton lens. Here also you are getting the different fringe pattern, the constructive and destructive pattern. Here also there is a formation of thin film. When you start observing the lenses, one is without reflecting, other one is with reflection coating. Here also in the glass plate, so we are putting the anti-reflection coating thin film to avoid unnecessary light. So it is very common to see rainbow pattern when you look at the surface of the CD and also when you look at the soap bubbles or the thin film of oil floating on the steel coating. All these effects are created by constructive and destructive interference of the light hitting the film. So here the interference, we have to read the definitions and conditions. What are the types of interference? One is wavefront, there is a Young's double slit experiment, the other one is amplitude splitting. Here we are reading the interference pattern, the wedge shape of film and Newton rings and Michelson interferometer. So what is the thin film? How can you define? A optical medium is called a thin film when its thickness is about the order of one wavelength of the light in visible region. That is said to be the thin film. So that thickness of the film is in the range of 0.5 micrometers to 10 micrometers considered as a thin film. So this is the visible spectrum. So the thickness is in the range of one order of visible wavelength region. So this is the definition of interference. The two light rays which are get superimposed with each other and produce the constructive and destructive interference phenomena. So you can define this modification intensity distribution resulting from the superposition of two waves like called interference. and the pattern of bright and dark fringes produces is called interference pattern. What is the condition for interference? The interference conditions are the light should be monochromatic and should be coherent. The coherent means nothing but it produces constant phase difference with respect to each other, and it has to satisfy the superposition principle. So this is the soap film interference. Here, especially in the soap film, there are two layers are there, the top layer and second layer of the soap film. One light reflected from the top layer, the other one is reflected from the second layer. So both these two reflected rays from the top layer and the down layer get superimposed with each other and produces the different color pattern through the interference phenomena. And one more thing is, the interference phenomena cannot be possible with the thick film. It is only possible with the thin film. So these are the books we are following for the interference: optics by Vadhanu and Gatter, and University of Physics Szymanski. So let me look at one video which shows the interest about the interference and thin films. See the color pattern on the soap film. So we are getting it constructed from dark frequency. Here we are using the white light. That's the reason you are observing the different color pattern on the screen. So you can see the different color pattern. I'm getting dark fringes as well as the bright fringes. In the case of interference, we have to understand that thin film thickness is a major place and important role to get the different color pattern on the screen. Thank you for watching.